building a driveway for a feller here. I built a shop, and now he's getting ready to build a barn dominium. A lot of barn dominiums going up in Middle Tennessee. And this is first thing in the morning here. And that's my first shot. I'll get better at this. But first step, you know, I removed the topsoil. Dug down about a foot deep. And I didn't get all the way to the hard pan, but the ground's pretty solid there. And I'm going to be bringing in chert. And that's going to be the base. And after his construction's done, he's going to top the chert with crusher run. And yeah, this is just more me of removing the soil. And here's, this is a little bit closer to the house here. He wanted me to make a little turn into his entrance and stuff. And here's the turn. I should have did a better job of filming. I really didn't have time though. I had two trucks coming at me, and they were only, his chert pit is only about 6 minutes from this job site, and two trucks on me was really a challenge for me. Really a challenge to keep up. Now here's my transit. I got these culverts. Got them where there's about 3 inches of fall. Those are 20 foot long. There's about 2 to 3 inches of fall from one end to the other. And you know, we use those fence posts to keep them in place. And then I just put chert in around them with a skid steer. And, you know, packed it down, and it finally ended up running on top of it once you got enough built up on there. Had my cousin doing some filming here. I probably too picky. I tell him, zoom in, make it look interesting. And then now watching, he's like, man, why are they zooming in so much? I guess because I told him to. So finally, you know, we got plenty of chert. We can cross the culverts. And I said 3 inches. It may actually only been 1 inch now to come to think of it. I only had 1 inch of fall. 3 inches over 20 foot really ain't that necessary. Had the truck drivers work these loads in. There's me over on the right-hand side running the drone. I'm using this Anthony Oliver song. I don't know if I'm allowed to do this or not. I know YouTube copyrights me. Good shot of me eating dust there. I work these sides in with my dozer. It weighs 22,000 pounds. That's a D38 Komatsu. Like I said, 22,000 pounds. It's wide tracks, so it doesn't pack as good as is a dozer that doesn't have wide tracks, but you know, it does good for the sides. I always work the chert in on the driveway with a loaded truck. And in southern Middle Tennessee or Tennessee period, you know, your truck can weigh 74,000 pounds. I'm gonna say that's about what these trucks were weighing when they was bringing me the chert in. Another shot of this feller here working in the loads. Walking it in is what we call it. Man, that was some real good chert. And I'm telling you, boy, it was just the right moisture to really work it good. But man, when this stuff dries,
let me give y'all a little advice, like, tell you why I'm thinking about it. If you get you a fuel cell, make sure you put you an inline filter on there. My daggum Dodge, I've had trouble out of it because, you know, sometimes you're running low on fuel, put some out of your fuel cell straight in your truck, make it home, whatever, make it to the fuel station. But I've had trouble out of it. I've had to change filters on my equipment. And these fuel cells are bad about getting dirt and water and condensation and stuff riding around in the back of your truck. So yeah, I got this filter here at Napa and stuff. I highly recommend it. It's a Wix. Here, let me just give you, might have to pause that. There's your part numbers. Let's see if this culvert gives any when he crosses it.
What I was saying earlier is when that chert dries, it sets up like concrete. nice. She moves a little bit. I don't think it's gonna hurt it none, especially once that church dries out. He didn't move much. Good driver out there. Heck yeah, let's get her done. 30 loads up in through here. It's 4:30. I got here at 7 o'clock this morning. We built that shop for that guy. His driveway. I'm gonna build him a level pad right there. Build him a house. Man, I sure appreciate y'all watching. I'm not too YouTube savvy. I don't know what people like, to be honest, and this may not do good, and if it don't, I'll just quit making content. But hell, if it does, I'll keep on making content. I may end up hiring a cameraman so I can get more in detail. Y'all have a good one. Do it for Dale.